Hello friends and welcome back to my channel. I've recently read an excellent article by Jess Liu entitled A Critical Review of Gen AI Policies in Higher Education Assessment, A Call to Reconsider the Originality of Students' Work. Reading this article prompted me to think about how we undertake assessments in higher education and whether we should be assessing students on product or process in the age of generative artificial intelligence, or Gen AI. At the end of this video, and based on the article, I'll make three process suggestions for reconsidering assessment approaches in the age of Gen AI. So do stick around until the end. This article explores the Gen AI policies of 20 world-leading universities using Bakke's What's the Problem Represented to Be framework. In the paper that I encourage you all to read, Liu found that the primary focus of the Gen AI policies tended to be based on concerns that the students may not be submitting their original work for assessments. The framing of the policy, Liu argues, tends to present Gen AI as a type of external assistant that is seen as separate from the student's independent efforts and intellectual contribution. So using AI tools is seen as undermining the originality of the student's work, and in the worst case scenarios, looked at as potentially cheating. The paper explores the concept of originality, pointing out that in the Gen AI age, students would be expected to complete all the necessary stages of their work without any AI assistance. But in an age where Gen AI tools are freely available to all students to use, is this really a realistic position to take? And is it fair to penalise students by preventing them from using AI? Or worse still, hiding their use of AI? Especially if they'll use AI tools in their future work roles. Thinking about the arguments presented in the paper, I'd argue that focusing solely on the final product of learning, like an essay, is like judging a software engineer solely on the final app that they produce. Wouldn't it be fairer if we could design assessments that assess the hours spent researching, analysing, questioning, and finally crafting that perfect product? What if we could assess the messy, beautiful process of learning? This paper prompted me to think more about the concept of originality and why, as educators, we should assess the process and not just the final product. Now, some suggested approaches could involve using open book exams, where AI can be used as a research assistant, where here students would not be penalised for using AI, but rather judged on how they critically analyse the information produced, check its originality, potential for bias, and then use the outputs to solve the presenting problems, thereby encouraging the students to articulate their thought processes. Or imagine asking students to create presentations using AI as an assistant. Here, students could be encouraged to not just present facts, but showcase their ability to dissect information, synthesize their ideas, and connect with their audience through question and answer sessions. These types of methods should encourage a shift in approach from assessing students purely on what they know, to what they know and how they think, learn, and reflect when using AI tools. A change in assessments of this nature aren't without their challenges. So thought has to go into how we assess the different elements of the learning process. So we have to consider how we can create fair and effective assessment tools and guidance that offers transparency to the educators and the students alike. It's a complex puzzle, but one that we really should embrace. I know you may be thinking, well, why should we embrace these challenges? Well, we can't really hide from the fact that AI tools are freely available and will become more and more sophisticated over time. So, as educators, do we want to create students who are masters at gaming the system, who can churn out AI-generated essays undetected? Or do we want to encourage AI use so that we can develop critical thinkers, innovators, problem solvers who can use AI to thrive in a world increasingly interwoven with technology? I'd say the latter. It's about preparing our students for a future where creativity, critical thinking, and the ability to navigate information overload will be worth its weight in gold. This is because in the age of AI, it's not just what you create, but how you create it that really matters. When reconsidering assessment approaches, I think it's really, really important to do this in partnership with the different stakeholders. Drawing from Lou's paper, here's three suggestions that I found really helpful. First, involve consultation meetings, seminars, and debates to look deeper into what the concept of originality in education means at your institution. Partner with students and academics to explore their perspectives on Gen AI and consider reworking the definition of originality in a Gen AI age. Second, emphasize open communication and collaboration with students and academics instead of prioritizing compliance when creating policies so that a culture of trust and care is cultivated within the institution. Finally, use the refined definition of originality to agree what specific aspects of students' work should be considered original to ensure students and academics are clear about what constitutes academic misconduct. There are other suggestions in the paper. Do make sure you explore it. The link is provided in the section below. So next time you want to create or recreate an assessment, think about what you can do to ensure that students are not just focusing on the final grade. Try and be creative in your assessment so that learners' journeys and the messy processes of learning and thinking are valued and rewarded as part of the final mark. This is important because in the end, it's that journey, not the destination, that will equip students for the amazing, challenging, AI-powered future that awaits them. But you know what? Let's not end the conversation here. Use the comments section below and share your thoughts. Should we assess students on product or process? Also consider, is the future of education human-powered, AI-assisted, or somewhere in between? I'd love to explore this brave new world together and pave the way for a future where learning thrives, not just survives in the age of Gen AI. I hope that you found this video useful. Please make sure that you like the video and consider subscribing to my channel. I've also put a link here to some other videos that you may find useful. Thank you for watching, and I look forward to seeing you next time. Bye.